Bună ziua și bun găsit la o nouă ediție a emisiunii Rom European. Astăzi vă vom prezenta două concerte susținute de două trupe ce au influențe din muzica și cultura romanii. Evenimentele au fost organizate în București sub umbrela Balkan Party. Așa că rămâneți alături de noi pentru a-i descoperi pe artiștii de la Dubioza Collective, dar și pe cei de la Al Jawala.
Please welcome to our guest, Dubioza Collective!
De ce Dubioza Collective? De ce acest concert?
Pentru că lumea îi place, pentru că au un mesaj care prinde foarte bine pentru vremurile pe care le trăim, pentru că au luat niște premii, pentru că fac atmosferă și pentru că nu au fost încă în București.
Dubioza Collective a fost capul de afiș al evenimentului Balkan Party, organizat în clubul The Silver Church din București. Denumiți pe bună dreptate senzația Bosniei, Dubioza Collective a cucerit întreaga Europa printr-un stil muzical aparte ce îmbină hip-hop, reggae, dubstep, rock și folclor bosniac. How could you define your music style?
Actually, we don't even try to do it because for us, first thing is to develop a concept of certain song or an album, and the lyrics and main idea it's what we are thinking about all the time. So then we just when we find the right topics and right ideas, we're just searching to find best musical background for that. So that's why probably it's music is very mixed with lots of genres and styles inside.
We always try to find the best musical, let's say, vessel for a message we're trying to communicate with the audience. So we kind of always choose a musical style according to idea of the song or idea of the album. So that's why the sound is eclectic and it can goes from, you know, traditional music to dubstep. It's like it can go anywhere.
What's the message of your music? What are you speaking about in your lyrics?
When we started like 8 years ago, we started as musicians who played in different bands, and in certain points, in same time, all these bands kind of split up. So we didn't have job in that time. So we was thinking of doing something, some project that should be very political and very engaged. So we think, you know, what is the best to do it, and then we kind of understood that we should have a band that is going to be engaged in that way. So obviously all the messages is mainly for younger people, because like 8 years ago in Bosnia there was no such a band before, and it was like, if you talk about politics, especially young people, there was a shame that they didn't feel comfortable to talk about it. And we wanted to change that, and now like 8 years after, you have almost every band that is playing music, there is some message, more or less political and more or less engaged, but there is, even the pop bands now are doing it. So we kind of wanted to put these kind of stories in certain kind of fashion mood, so everybody could talk, because if you don't talk about it and if you don't think about it every day, you know, then government can do whatever. I mean, then democracy is for nothing. You don't use it. So actually the Bosnian community, and I think all ex-Yugoslavia community, and then all Eastern European community, need kind of more everyday training of how to use democracy.
E trupa care, de care cred că România are nevoie și ar fi foarte frumos să vedem și în România un astfel de band. E nevoie de curaj, e nevoie de să fii informat în primul rând și cred că e nevoie de viziune ca să ai un asemenea discurs și pe care să-l știi, să-l susții și să-l arunci în oameni, oamenilor să le placă, să-l recunoască și să-l simtă.
I think that essentially we didn't change much. Of course, after this 8 years band grew in many ways. I mean, in our set list we still have a few songs from our first album, so I don't think that essentially it's been changed. I mean, we've been influenced by many other music that we heard in the meantime, plus we grew up as a musician. And what is most important for us is that we think that our message and our energy is still the same, like on the first album, and this form of packaging of these ideas and messages is not that important to us.
După 8 ani de existență și 6 albume la activ, cel mai recent fiind Wild Wild East, lansat în septembrie 2011, cei de la Dubioza Collective au un palmares ce l-ar face invidios pe orice muzician.
Our last album, Wild Wild East, is released in September of last year for Cool Arab Records, publishing company from San Francisco, USA, and it is all on English language.
Why all in English?
Actually, we started on English, and after that, due to all these events that happened in our country, we had like two really engaged, politically engaged albums on our language, because we want to support all that stuff that happened in our country and region. Then we toured a lot, you know, in the region and Europe, and we gathered enough of inspiration to make one album on English language, which could be interested for Romanian people as well.
We're going to promote this new album that came out in September last year, Wild Wild East, which is released for US and European market, and we are going to spend the entire year playing concerts in mostly in Europe. For now, a lot of festivals and clubs are already confirmed, so we know that we're going to spend at least half of the year just touring around and playing more in the countries that we haven't played before. I am from Bosnia, take me to America. I really want to see Statue of Liberty. I cannot learn the name, take me to United States. Take me to Golden Gate.
Au fost nominalizați pentru cel mai bun album independent al anului 2011 și recunoscuți de BBC și Time Magazine drept vocea muzicală a Bosniei.
All of us, we decided that this is the thing that is going to be our living, and everybody took it very seriously. And this determination of each person in a band, it's, I think, most important, because, you know, we really, you know, every show we play, we try to play it like it's the last show, and we see this as a, you know, project of our life. Hey, 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 hey.
This was our first Romanian club concert, because two previous times we played in festivals. So club audience is always different, because they always come for one band and they like really want to see you. And because of the weather, that was last night, we thought that like, you know, very few people would come, but in the end the attendance was really good and the energy was good because people really wanted to see us, and that was a really good sign that, that we have audience. Hey, 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 hey.
Cum a fost concertul de aseară din București?
Este exact același feedback, aceeași reacție pe care o au Dubioza Colectiv oriunde ar merge. Pentru că au un sunet foarte bun, au un mesaj foarte puternic, pentru că acești băieți trăiesc ceea ce cântă și pentru că sunt mesajele lor ajung foarte bine și foarte repede la oameni.
De-a doua ediție, Balkan Party a avut loc în Kulturhaus București, unde a concertat cea mai în vogă trupă germană de Balkan Beatbeats, Al Jawala.
Al Jawala în 2007 a câștigat cea mai prestigioasă competiție de world music din Germania. Al Jawala a reușit în sala de operă de la Stuttgart să câștige două premii în aceeași seară. Premiul juriului și premiul oferit de audiență al publicului.
Stilul unic al celor de la Al Jawala ignoră toate limitările și clișeele, adăugând fără compromisuri și cu o creativitate debordantă accente de rock and roll unor stiluri muzicale tradiționale precum cel romani, african, est-european și chiar arabic.
How can you describe your music style?
Well, if you want a short version, we just go like it's Balkan big beats. Our music makes people dance, is a very energetic music, is also, it comes from our backgrounds. Like I grew up with maybe Beastie Boys, Red Hot Chili Peppers, with hip hop, also with rock. So all this, everybody of the band members brings his own personal background into the music. And then you still have the Balkan influences. And this together is like the Balkan big beat. So I think this is still the best word for our music style.
București! El Jawala all the way from Germany.
Din fericire pentru mine, arta se împarte în două direcții, firesc, nefiresc. Nu sunt de acord cu niciun demers muzical, atâta vreme cât văd clar că intenția de a cânta un anumit gen de muzică e făcută strict din punct de vedere comercial.
Al Jawala este firesc sau nefiresc?
Extrem de firesc. Cred că genul de muzică pe care l-au abordat ei e pur și simplu din pasiune.
In the earlier years we still do it, but we did a lot of music in the street, like playing on the street. So we are very used to people, we are very used to have people also close by. And I think when we are on stage, people can still feel our closeness, so that it's not like separated, like it's the artist and it's the audience, but it's like a thing which is very much together. A huge number of the songs or of the ideas and the images which are behind our music come from experiences we have while we are traveling. When we first came to Romania, this was 2005, when we got invited to Stuffstock Festival in Vama Veche. When we came with the van, like driving, we enter at Arad, And we made a stop, just, okay, we need a break from the road, we have a breakfast, we just enter in this restaurant, eat something, chill out a little bit. So we enter, this was maybe 10 in the morning, and the radio was on. And the music was like, very wild, very fast, very... And I said, whoa, what's that? And so it's Manele music. And so we started to listen more and more to Manele because for us it's exotic. It don't exist in Germany, in Western Europe.
Dacă ne uităm atent la albumele făcute până în 2005 și la albumele editate după aceea, se poate vedea foarte clar că deja ei vorbesc din propria experiență. Albumul care l-au ascuns ulterior, Last in Manele, Asphalt Pirate Radio, sau sunt albume, teme muzicale care redau experiența lor pe tărâmul românesc. Piese ca Microbuzul sau De ce bat vântul frunzele sau... Sunt piese din propriile lor experiențe personale, pentru că au venit cu mașina prima dată și au făcut 900 de kilometri până la Vama Veche, pe teritoriul românesc.
I remember 2 days and nights of jamming with the other bands. They invited us on the stage, hey, play with us, and it was really an exchange, but from the first moment. So really direct contact to the people, and this is what I love about Romanian people the most.
Faptul că s-au întâlnit cu muzicieni români de etnie romă, de fapt, la festival Play și au făcut un jam session în spatele backstage-ului. Fiecare cântec a fost construit corect. N-a fost o chestie genul, haideți să ne pregătim pentru... Multă lume poate înțelege greșit. Algeval a venit în România și a făcut temele și studiază folclor românesc. Greșit. Albumele respective, respectiv ultimele trei, au foarte mare legătură cu România pentru că ei au avut o legătură constantă cu... România. Au cântat totuși la festivalul Sustoc de 2 ori, au cântat la festivalul Play de 2 ori, au susținut numeroase reprezentații live în România și și-au format o comunitate de fani și au legat o legătură directă, sinceră, cu ce reprezintă România, așa cum o văd eu și cum o văd ei.
You have an album called
Lost in Manele.
Lost in Manele. Why?
this was the album Lost in Manele. It's a live album. First of all, it's from 2007. In this time we were spending a lot of time regularly in Romania, working a lot also with money from Urma, and also to find the album title. I remember the longer we talk about this issue, we realize that in Romania people have a very different attitude towards Manele. This is why we chose the title, because of these two extremes. Yeah, you know, I mean, it's like that we are still constantly moving between an old and precious traditional thing and a modern entertaining thing. Of course, a band, we also want to entertain in terms that when people come and see us, they should have a good time, they should like relax and dance and feel happy and stuff. But to manage to do this on a high level, yeah, not to start become cheap in the way the music develops, so.
Turneul Bless Your Ghetto promovează cel de-al 6-lea album al trupei, denumit The Ride.
And Joanna, Bless Your Ghetto Tour. And with Bless Your Ghetto, we don't mean only the ghetto blaster, but we mean Bless Your Ghetto. We mean like bouncing over the border. Bucuresti, are you ready to jump over the border now with us? Are you ready for it?
Ultimul lor album e pur și simplu intitulat sugestiv The Ride, pentru că ei au încercat o producție puțin atipică față de cum au lucrat inițial. Eu, cel puțin așa cum am perceput eu muzica Algeavala și cum am văzut-o în formare, primele lor două albume erau albume editate live, apoi au început încet să cocheteze cu studio. Cred că albumul ăsta reflectă mai mult munca și introspecția lor, munca înăuntru unui studio. E un album puțin mai elaborat și în care au încercat să facă un rezumat al călătoriei lor în ultimii 12 ani de când este înființată formația.
Now we have the whole circle with the band name El Jawala, which means like traveling, moving, and the album title The Ride, which is the action of moving, yeah, riding a bicycle, riding a bus. Yeah. So I think the album up to now is the completest work we did. It's the most diversitive work also like the spectrum of styles. It will reach now from reggae over cumbia, Latin music, going back to like strictly Balkan beats, but also becoming very lyrical. And also new is that we started to like use our voice, like we now start also to sing on our own music, what we did not do up to now, because we're supposed to work like an instrumental band for the last 10, 11 years.
Aceasta a fost ediția de astăzi. Eu sunt Loredana Dumitru și vă aștept și săptămâna viitoare la aceeași oră. Până atunci, să trăiți mișto! Proiect cofinanțat din Fondul Social European prin Programul Operațional Sectorial Dezvoltarea Resurselor Umane 2007-2013. Investește în oameni.